So guys, this week's video is going to be fall themed. So what I'll be doing is my fall painting. And yeah, hope you guys enjoy it. I'm going to be doing an autumn landscape today, and I hope you all enjoy. I'm also going to be having a video, like a story time. I'm going to be doing a story time today, and I hope you enjoy it, because it is one that I have told so many times. And stick around till the end. Bye!
So guys, today is the story time that you have all been waiting for. Well, you know, maybe not, but I'm going to tell you anyway. So, the story time today is the time that I was painting and got set on fire. Yes, on fire.
This girl is on fire! This girl is on fire!
So, back a few years ago, I was working on a painting and I was in my living room / dining room / kitchen. I had a place I was living in that was kind of like all those three were combined. There was a big L-shaped couch facing the farthest wall in the apartment that had like the TV window and the window on it. And the couch was facing the TV, and the table that I was at painting at was behind the couch, so anyone who was sitting on the couch wouldn't be able to see what I was doing. Only people who were in the kitchen area could see me, because it was like the island was in between where I was and the people in the kitchen. I had set up my art easel and all the paints and the computer on the table, and I was listening to like some like old 1950s movies or something, like suspense movies. So I lit the candle because it was mid-autumn and it was starting to get cold out and just looked aesthetically pleasing. So the candle I lit was on the table next to my computer, kind of near my painting supplies and whatnot, but not like next to my painting supplies. It was behind it, so it wasn't near anything that could catch on fire or anything like that. So about an hour into the painting session, I get up and I'm kind of like, you know, checking out the painting, looking at it from all sort of distances, making sure it looked the way I wanted it to look. And as I was moving back, I just felt my arm just felt like it was on fire, and just like a pinching sort of pain. And I reacted like super fast, and I just grabbed my flannel, because I was wearing a flannel over a t-shirt, and thank God that this flannel was open, like it wasn't buttoned up. So I reached for the arm of the flannel and I throw it off. So I just kind of like take a moment to look around and, you know, figure out what happened, because in my mind, keep in mind, the candle is still on the table, right? Well, no. The candle had been moved. My mom, bless her heart, had taken the candle and moved it to the island thing right behind me, because she thought that the candle could like fall off the table and set something on fire. So she didn't want it to be like a dangerous thing for the candle to be lit. And I didn't see her move it, of course, because I had headphones in and I was kind of like in tunnel vision while I was painting. So once I had put together like all of these things, I came to the conclusion that I had been set on fire. Yeah. And my dad is sitting on the couch. He all of a sudden says, it smells like burning flesh in here. Like, that's weird. And I'm like, yeah. Yeah, that is weird, isn't it? And of course I don't say, yeah, because I'm on fire. No. I got up and I went and checked out the, you know, the situation. I went and checked out the situation in the bathroom and, like, looked at my arm. My arm had been singed, like, all the hair was gone. And, like, that's not that bad. But the hand that I put out the fire with, essentially, was burnt. I think I had, like, second degree burns on my entire hand. So that was fun. And then when I came out of the bathroom, I got the shirt off the ground and looked, and there was a huge, huge burnt hole out of the side of my flannel, which it was actually a very big baggy flannel that didn't fit me. And so I don't think if it would have been like tight, like a tight flannel, it wouldn't have been as easy to get off, for one, and two, I think it would have been closer to my skin, so it would have burned me a lot worse. So the situation, after all, wasn't that bad. So that's good. But yeah, hopefully y'all never light a candle or a fire, flames of any sort, unless you are watching it. No unsupervised flames, please. Learn from my mistakes. Learn from them. Hey guys, I hope you enjoyed that video. I hope you all learned from my mistakes. And don't play with fire, kids. Stay positive. Bye.